بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. In this next session of the Hadith Challenge, we will be looking at one Hadith which is with respect to the company a person keeps, or the people whom he loves to remain in their company. So the Hadith is Al-Mar'u Ma'a Man Ahab. Again, Al-Mar'u Ma'a Man Ahab, the translation of which is a person will be with whom he loves. So again, the hadith is Al-Mar'u Ma'a Man Ahab. A person will be with whom he loves. Now the context of this hadith. This was in response to a person who inquired that, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what do you say about someone who loves a group of people but is unable to join them? What do you say about someone who loves a group of people but is unable to join them? So when he is talking about a group of people, then this is referring to the pious, the devout worshippers, or the scholars of sacred knowledge. And this is with respect to the fact that he is unable either to gain their company or achieve a status like theirs in knowledge or in deeds, whatever reason it might be. There can be countless reasons, but he is unable to either gain their company or to achieve a status of theirs in knowledge. He cannot learn like them. He cannot devote himself. He cannot free himself up for the sake of learning deen because of some necessary occupation in his life. Either he's taking care of someone, either he's taking care of the needs of the family. He cannot achieve their deeds for whatever reason. But he yearns, he wishes to be like them. So in response to this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab, a person will be with whom he loves. And this is with respect to the akhirah, that he will be gathered with them on the day of judgment. He will be gathered with them on the day of judgment. Now, this leads us to a further discussion, a more general application of this hadith. That this hadith actually, or in its most basic sense, came down for someone who cannot attain the company of the pious in this world, but he will attain their company in the akhirah by loving them and by yearning to be with them. Just by this love and by this yearning, he will attain their company in the akhirah, even though he cannot attain their company in this world. So in the same vein, a person who has a yearning, he has a love of the lifestyle of the sinners. Just on by virtue of this desire to be like them, this yearning for the same deeds that they do, he can attain their company in the akhirah, even though he would not have committed the same sins as them in this world. And this is a further discussion which does come up in a hadith that, this hadith is mentioned in Riyadh al-Salihin. That when two Muslims, they pick up swords and they fight each other, then both of them are in the fire. Then Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said that, O Rasulullah, we understand that person who killed his brother, that he will be in the fire. Why the one who got killed? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentions that he had a full intention to do the same. So the meaning of which is that he was ready, he was fully equipped, and if he had the ability, then he would have done it. So just by virtue of his intention and by being prepared and by having the means, by preparing whatever the means that he was able to bring, he will be in the same position as the one who actually carried out the deed. So it is very important that we guard ourselves, that in this month of Ramadan, we might not have the same capacity to do everything that we were doing in a regular year. By someone, we might not have the same means to do the same deeds as someone who might be more free than us. But we have this yearning, we have this desire in our heart that, Ya Allah, I love to be like the people of knowledge. I love to be like the people who have devoted themselves for the sake of your ibadah. Ya Allah, I am tied up, I am strapped down by other necessities in my life, by other engagements. But Ya Allah, I wish to be like these pious people. Inshallah, Allah will give us a status like theirs. And if on the other hand, we look at the people of sin, we look at the people who are gaining the displeasure of Allah, then we should be very careful. That just by this love and by this yearning, this might bring us to the same level as theirs, even though we might not have committed the same deeds as them. May Allah give us the tawfiq to do those deeds which are pleasing to Him. May Allah give us the tawfiq to stay away from those deeds and those actions which are displeasing to Him. وآخر الدعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحان الله وبحمده سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين